look at the bait right here. Look at the fish underneath the bait. See them?
Yeah.
This really is video fishing. I mean, you watch it. See, look at the fish right here coming up. See the fish at 40 feet?
Mm-hmm.
So you can see the fish when they're coming up to the boat.
This is all, I would say, new to me, but you know, to me, fishing's fishing. You're trying to fool a fish with a brain about the size of a pea. And
let's see if we can fool these. These fish are definitely right here.
It all looks good.
It all looks good. It looks better with a bent rod, but it all looks good.
Well, welcome to this episode of Addicted Fishing, folks. We are out of our element, or at least I say I'm out of my element. I'm fishing, what are we, 120 foot of freshwater right now. Got Bill Carson with us from Johnson Outdoors, and we're catching stripers today. We're gonna give it a shot anyway. We're supposed to be way down south, but Mother Nature has changed our plans for us, so. Drove 7 hours north to see Bill. Oh, just had a hit. Anyway, drove about 7 hours north instead of 7 hours south to the Keys, so. We're gonna see if we can show you what I'm gonna call a multi-striped snook.
There you go, multi-striped snook, I like that.
A multi-striped snook. And they do put R's in striper here in Georgia, don't they?
Yes, sir.
Not a stripe-a, but a striper.
That's correct. All it's right. Stripe-a when you go way to the north,
that's
right?
That's it, and on bunkas.
Bunkas and stripers.
So y'all stay tuned, we're gonna see if we can show you some multi-striped snook from Lake Lanier.
Yeah, these guys right on the bottom. Oh, here's one right here.
Get him, son.
It's y'all.
And that's what they do, huh?
That's what they do. When they eat, they eat.
That looks like it might be a grown one, huh?
I don't know. They're pretty sparky.
Well, when I was guiding, I had a lot of people come down from this part of Georgia that used to absolutely love to come down here to catch, or come down to Florida to catch redfish.
Right.
And they'd always compare the redfish fights as the striper fights.
It's very similar. This is not a big fish, but it's a good fish because it bit.
Yeah. Like I almost say in every show, they're all good, just some are better than the others, right?
That's right.
So this would be the first, or now these are landlocked, right?
These are landlocked. These are the Atlantic Coast strain, the same ones that go up and down from the Straits of Maine all the way up and down to the Outer Banks of the Carolinas. Man, those trocar hooks are awesome.
They are unbelievable.
Watch your thumb, man, because it'll go through your thumbnail.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me they had teeth.
No, I'm just going to tell you that you've got a trocar hook in there, and those things are not forgiving.
Can you lip these stripers?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Well, they almost look a little bit like a snook. They got some stripes.
They do have some stripes.
Get that trocar out.
You don't want to play with that trocar? Is that what you're
saying? Nah, it's all right. I've had plenty of them through my fingers, and... Hang on, I should roll it out. There we go. There we go, a striper. That's a pretty fish.
They are pretty fish. He's looking at you like he's mad at you.
Ooh, get on out of here then. Good fish, brother.
Yeah, man, that's awesome.
Hey, our original plan was to be down in Chokoloskee right now, but Mother Nature has put a kibosh on our fishing down there. It seems like it happens every time. But we're fishing with Bill Carson, who happens to be the man when it comes to video fishing.
This is video fishing. This you saw how we saw those at like 30, 40 feet, coming up and down, and then bam.
So if y'all want to learn how to use your Humminbird product right, y'all stay tuned to this show because we got the man on the boat. We'll be right back with some more Addicted Fishing and Bill Carson. Let's go then. I got a fish on this one. Yes, I do. I was just freelining, he was on there. Feels like a pretty good fish, brother. Dang. Is that trees or fish?
That is a fish, my friend.
Every once in a while, you can see where your line drops down in them.
You definitely can.
Well, welcome back, folks. We're still sitting here on one of the most beautiful lakes in Georgia I have ever seen in my life. It's Lake Lanier. Bill Carson's with us. He is the striper man on this lake, and we've relocated now. We're sitting on a race, and you got the Lake Master chip. This is all new to me, folks. So he's got a Lake Master chip in my unit here, and what it is, he's set up where he's found 35 foot depth around. We came up just on the other side of the sandbar, as you'll see on the Humminbird there. Hit spot lock, don't have to throw an anchor, and vertically jig fishing along with two live baits on the side. So
Yeah, guys have come to realize that spot lock is an incredible invention. You know, if we're in 35 feet of water, I mean, how much scope of anchor line do you have to have out in 35 feet to hold a boat?
Well, with no current here, you're supposedly, what, 70?
80 feet. Yeah.
I got a fish on this one. Yes, I do. That was free line. That was just free line and he was on there. Feels like a pretty good fish, brother. Then again, they all feel good, right?
Well, and the cool thing about this is that we're staying in the same place. We're spot locked right here. Let me get this out of your way.
Please.
Before we have a major mess.
Oh, yeah.
That's the right color.
That's the right color. Man, they do have like a redfish tug to them.
Yep.
You say all these fish were, and they still do releases in here for these guys, right?
They do releases in here every year. This lake is 38,000 acres. Deep water, gin clear.
Full of stripers. And one less catfish.
One less catfish, plenty of stripers.
Well, you got that one.
That's about the average size going right now. Are you kissing that fish? Is that what's going on?
I'm doing all kinds of things with that fish. He's gonna have to keep that hook. And they'll come out on their own, right?
That is correct.
What a pretty fish. Are all their lines the same? Do they have the same amount of lines, each fish, or are they all different?
It depends on the size of the fish, but you can tell, you know, how they are based on broken lines. So a hybrid looks
down.
Totally different. Straight down, just torpedoing down, boom, and he's gone.
And off he goes. So what were you saying about the stripes?
The hybrids have broken lines, and a hybrid is a cross between a white bass and a striped bass.
Yeah, we get
they
those down in
reproduce.
Florida.
Right. And the thing about it is like in Georgia, there's only one river system that the stripers can reproduce in any numbers, and that's the Coosa and Istanali over in Rome, Georgia, coming out of Lake Wise.
In other words, that's a lot of information for people to process. You need to write a book. Pay attention to this show because it's a wealth of information coming out of this man right here. Y'all stay tuned. We're going to be right back. Going to get re-rigged and catch another striper.
Let's do it.
Let's go then.
Oh, fish on. Fish.
There he is. Ooh. Some drag, baby.
Look how these things scale. You know, you were talking about them scaling like the Spanish sardines, is
yeah.
That what you said? Look at all those on my hand.
Like
they're gonna be all over your rods. You're gonna have to hose them down with the pressure washer.
Well, welcome back, folks. We're changing spots now. We're sitting, I don't know, one of his favorite spots. I think every spot on this lake is his favorite spot, but because everywhere you hit 35 feet with a hummingbird, you find fish. It's just soaking baits on the bottom. We're doing a little different now. We got two live baits down on the bottom here with a little bit heavier rigs. And we're instead of jigging the jigs like we were doing, basically putting the live bait down on a split shot and seeing what happens. Y'all are seeing what
I've
happens
actually
here.
Caught a couple of walleye here before.
Really?
Yep.
That all baited up. What kind of baits are these, Bill?
These are blueback herring. And what happens is people go and catch these bait guys do. They catch them under sodium lights in some of the big lakes.
They almost look like scaled sardines, what we use in salt water.
Yeah.
They definitely, all the scales off it, definitely seem like
they got. They got introduced illegally into a lot of lakes. And part of the reason for striped bass being put into a lot of lakes is to help contain. They're like rabbits. They just multiply like crazy.
What, that the herring?
Yes, and the reason why striped bass were picked as the species to help keep those at bay, if you will, is because in the summertime when the thermocline gets built up, these blueback herring go out and they go to the same places the stripers are. So the food source is right there. You have thread fennel go up and stay on the top.
Yeah.
You know, in a lot of states, there's not that much flow because we dam up the rivers and you don't realize it, but for water to go from point A to point B, oh, I think we may have a fish here. Oh. Yep, we do.
Yeah, we do. How about that? We'll get back to point A and point B in a second.
Yeah.
What
A walleye! A walleye! We got dinner, buddy! Woo-hoo!
Walleye on the skeeter.
Well, you know what? This is the perfect example of the other fish that they put in order to control the blueback herring or attempt to. So they put about 30,000 or so walleye in here. You throw him back, I'm throwing you back.
That's what I saw stick his head up out of the water.
That is dinner right there, buddy.
That is a cool fish. Hey, folks, my first walleye I've ever touched. That teeth like a saltwater fish.
Yes, sir.
So what do they taste like?
It's white. It is a very firm meat.
You can tell that. It feels like a gar almost.
It's incredible fish to eat. You will absolutely love it.
Well, let's get this one on the cooler and see if we can get one more.
Let's get him on the ice. There's a bunch of fish on the bottom right here for sure.
This water's pretty clean now. This is Lake Everett. I guess freshwater lakes, they turn over?
Yeah, they do. There's an inversion. It'll look like split pea soup when you go over the dam.
Kind of like the Pea River, huh?
That's right.
The Pea River. Hey, what are you doing over there?
I was trying to get my rod in position.
You got a handful of that Procure. Oh, fish on, fish. There he is. Oh, some drag, baby. Making this 8-footer pull some drag. That might be a good fish.
It is a good fish.
Got him trained. They're all good. Come on, let's see a multi-striped snook again. Oh, Bill, this is so different than what I normally do. I am definitely out of my element. What in the world is that? It's red looking. Oh, it is a nice striper. They got some power, don't they?
They can swim. They take it where they want to take it.
Oh, gotcha. That circle hook right in the mouth. Oh, there we go. Mr. Striper. Neat fish. Like I said, I'm totally out of my element. And for you guys that just tune in for the saltwater stuff, you gotta come do some freshwater in Lake Lanier. This is some neat stuff. Beautiful fish. And off he goes. What's the size limits on these, Bill?
You can have two over 22 inches long. On shorter fish, you can have 15 per person.
15.
But most people don't keep the fish.
Yeah, and you say they do releases in here of a 300,000 or something?
750,000 on a good year. They'll release 750,000. It's all put and take. These really are a saltwater fish. These fish are raised in hatcheries from eggs that they take from saltwater fish.
That's pretty cool stuff. Well, y'all stay tuned. We're going to be right back with some more addictive fishing and hopefully a few more stripers. We want one of them double digits. What do you call them, teenagers?
Teenagers.
We'll be right back with a teenager. Y'all stay tuned. Let's go then. Hey, there he is. It's a double. I got a double.
It's a double. He got two of them.
I got a double, baby.
Rig It Right by Wright & McGill.
On today's Rig It Right, I'm going to show you what Bill and I were out there using. But first, I want to tell you a little bit about Lake Lanier. One of the most beautiful places I've ever fished and has to be the deepest freshwater places I've ever fished in my life as well. Bill told me, he said, you know, this place is known for stripers, but I've only heard up there you can catch them in the wintertime because they come up in school. And when I told him that, he said, Blair, I got a video fishing game for you you're going to love. We're going to use the hummingbird to find the fish. And what he's done, he lives up there and he trolled around, and with the Lake Master chip, he mapped the bottom at a 35 foot level. And when you look at it, it's a nice big green area on your hummingbird chart. And all you have to do is troll around that 35 foot level and you can see the fish. The rigs we were using the 7-9 bait casters, and we were trolling, and wait till you see this. We were trolling the Eagle Claw, and this is the Eagle Claw bucktail jig with the DOA 4-inch cow swim bait. And we had it filled up with the bait fish formula. This is the Procure stuff, works awesome. It stinks and it attracts the fish. But had the 7-9s rigged up, 15 pound test Smackdown by Seaguar, 20 pound test fluorocarbon leader, and we're using a little tiny Trocar circle hook. And basically just troll the live bait back behind us, and it was getting the job done. Now wait till you see the rig coming up, because I've never trolled with one of these things before. And to listen to Bill as we went by the fish,
saw the fish underneath the tree, and he said, we're not gonna get them on this side, we're gonna get them when we go back the other way. So we did a turn, went back, and boom, what do you see this? It was video fishing at its best. Remember one thing though? Every season starts right at Dick's.
Rig It Right by Wright & McGill.
Well, it got awfully hot, didn't it?
It is hot.
I'm glad we're trolling.
It's gonna get cooler after this hurricane or whatever it is comes ashore.
It definitely gets hot in Georgia when there ain't no wind.
No doubt about it.
That mark up there, you guys, is that the one you just put in there?
Yeah, when we came over, there was a piece of brush and there were a whole bunch of fish off to the side of it. So what I'm doing is I'm gonna go back and just try to clip the side of it where the fish were and see if we can't get somebody to reach up there and grab one of those DOA swim baits.
That'd be nice. We just need one more fish.
One more fish.
One more fish.
All right, here we go. We're coming up on it right now. Looks like there's somebody home.
They're still there, huh?
Yes, sir.
About 75 feet behind the boat.
Yeah, should be there about, right about now.
Oh, here, fish, fish, fish. Or that might be a snag. No. That's fish. Yep, that'd be a fish, baby. Come on, stay on to Mary Poppins.
If we take it out of gear, a lot of times what happens is the bounce and them going up and down.
Yeah.
That's when that's how those fish get off, because it's got all that weight on it.
That is a fish for show.
That's a fish for show.
So Bill, tell me, what is the optimal time to be down here to catch these things?
You can catch these fish all year long.
I know, I've always heard my buddies that are up here, that live up here, say, oh, you can only catch them October, November, December. That's the only time you can catch them.
You change your tactic, what you actually do.
Yeah, you video fish.
That's right, that's right. And that's what we're doing even with this, with the Mary Poppins rig, as you named it, is we're video fishing. We're going over, we're highlighting humps. We saw a tree there, right? So we worked around the tree, we figured out where the tree was, and we worked around it, and then we went back and got in the right position to catch the fish.
And you made three passes by that thing.
We made three passes by that thing.
Y'all didn't get to see all that. But you will see Blair do a very first on Addicted Fishing right here, I think. Another first. Hell, that'd be two first in one show,
right?
That's right,
a walleye, a striped bass on a Mary Poppins rig. I mean, that's awesome, dude.
The Mary Poppins. Hey, there he is. It's a double. I got a double.
It's a double. He got two of them.
I got a double, baby.
It's a double.
How many times you ever done that?
A few.
A few? Oh, so that's not a first, huh?
That's not a first.
Well, you're going to have to get down there and help me out with that.
It's your fish. What are you telling me? I'm just kidding.
Here, I'll get one. You get the other. Great way to end the day. And of course, look, you grabbed a big one. Oh, DOA came through again.
The DOA on the bucktail jig.
Little guy right there. Two stripers. Head down.
Head down.
Well, brother, it don't get much better than that. It's to end the day on a double like that. I can't put words in my mouth there. Well, definitely a first for me in Lake Lanier here, catching stripers. Want to say a special thanks out there to the Lake Lanier Island Resort. Awesome place. If you guys ever get a chance to come here and stay, it's incredible. I'm definitely going to come back here on vacation because it's nice. It's a definite good break away from saltwater. Definitely a good break.
Enjoyed it, my friend.
Appreciate the day. Don't forget about the website, addictivefishing.com, #showyourmogan on all the social media sites out there. And that about wraps it up, brother. Thank you very much for a great day on Lake Lanier.
Sounds good.
Woo!
Check out more footage from this show by logging on to addictivefishing.com for outtakes and bloopers.
Give him the Michael Phelps.
How did I call that? Kitty, 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 kitty. Oh, there he is. Oh, it's a tree.
Got me a tree. Thing came up out of the water. It looked like a little whale. It went boom.
A walleye!
A walleye!
We got dinner, buddy! Woo-hoo!